This is Murali Krishna, Department of Chemistry, DBS Engineering College, Kava. Last video, already we discussed about some important models in state of methods. So today also you can go for and discuss about some models in this lesson. Look here. Finally, RMS speed or RMS velocity of SO2. Finally, RMS velocity of SO2 at 27 degrees centigrade. So, the RMS velocity of any gas is always calculated by using of C is equal to root of 50 by m. That is equal to 1.58 into 10 squared into root of T by m. Whereas T is the temperature, m is molecular weight. So, here, the temperature is 27 degrees. It means 27 plus 27 degrees. That is equal to 300 Kelvin. And then the m is molecular weight. The molecular weight of SO2 is 64. Then you can substitute the values in the given formula. We can get 3.43 into 10 squared meter per second. This is the one of the model to calculate the RMS velocity of a gas. Another important one is nothing but, look here, friends, if 150 ml of carbon monoxide diffused in 25 seconds at 1 volume of methane will be diffused in same time. Here, look here, they can give two types of gases. One is carbon monoxide and one is methane. So carbon monoxide, methane, the molecular weight of carbon monoxide is 28. The molecular weight of methane is 16. Then you can calculate the volume of gas is equal to V1 by V2 is equal to root of M2 by M1. M2 and M1. M2 is nothing but methane. M1 is nothing but the carbon monoxide. Then you can substitute. The volume will be given at 150 ml. V1 is 150 ml. V2 is equal to plasma. Then M2 is equal to 60. Then M1 is equal to 28. Then you can calculate the value. Finally, you can get V2 is equal to 111.38 milliliters. This is the another important model where in the case of the states of matter. So, another one is nothing but calculate the pressure of a gas in mixture of 0.5 liters of hydrogen at 0.8 bar and 2 liters of oxygen at 0.7 bar are introduced in 1 liter weather at 27 degrees centigrade. So, friends, we can calculate the what is the total pressure of a gas. So, in this model, first of all, you can calculate the pressure of hydrogen and pressure of oxygen. Then you can add to this, then you can get the total pressure of a gas. Look here. The pressure of a mixture is always equal to the pressure of hydrogen and the pressure of oxygen. Then first of all you can calculate the pressure of hydrogen is equal to the pressure of hydrogen into volume of hydrogen by volume of pressure. So this is the formula to calculate the any pressure of a gas, not only hydrogen, not only hydrogen, oxygen, not only SO2, whatever it may be, the gas which is given in the problem, we should be go for use this kind of the formula to calculate the pressure of any gas. Is equal to pressure of H2 into volume of H2 by volume of pressure. So, already in the problem, the pressure of hydrogen is equal to 0.8. The volume of hydrogen is equal to 0.5, and the volume of the vessel, the total volume of the compound is 1 liter. That is equal to 0.8 into 0.5 by 1 is equal to 0.4 bar. This is the pressure of hydrogen. Similarly, we can calculate the pressure of oxygen. So same formula, pressure of oxygen, it is pressure of volume of oxygen by total volume of the vessel. Look here, the pressure of oxygen is equal to 2 bar, the pressure of oxygen is equal to 0.7, the volume of oxygen is equal to 2 liters, and the total volume of the vessel is equal to 1 liter. Then 2 into 0.7 by 1, that is equal to 1.24 bar. So therefore, the pressure of a mixture is always nothing but 0.4 plus 1.4 is equal to 1.8 bar. This is the total pressure of a gas in the given table. Similarly, friends, look here. Which of the following gas has the highest rate of effusion? Friends, the effusion of a gas always depends on its molecular weight. When a compound or any molecule which is having the less molecular weight, that kind of the compounds or gas is always good for very fast comparing with the high molecular weight. Look here, options is methane, CH4, SO2, helium and carbon dioxide. Look here friends, this is 60, this is 64, this is 4, this is carbon dioxide 32, that is equal to 40. So this is the molecular weight of the gases, 60, 64, 4 and then 40. Among these, which gas has the lower molecular weight? That compound or that gas is always go for a very fast comparing with the other one. So that's why in this one, helium is always a very fast gas because they have the lower molecular weight. And then the rate of the effusion of the any gas is directly proportional to or inversely proportional to one, it's a square root of molecular weight. That is equal to R1 by R3 is equal to root of M2 by M1. According to this formula, helium is always go for very fast comparing with the other gases. So these are the main important models which is present in this one. Again, we can discuss about some important models here. Look here, friends. So, the molar volume of the molar volume of an ideal gas at 1 atom and 273 degrees is here. We can tell that this is the formula of the compound P is equal to energy. So look here, this is the temperature. Generally, at STP, a gas is always occupied at 273 Kelvin, the gas is always occupied at 22.4 meters. But in the case of here, they can give 273 degrees. It means 273 plus 273. That is equal to 546 Kelvin. It means, look here, at 273 Kelvin, it occupies 22.4 meters, but 546 Kelvin, it occupies how much? It means, look here, that is equal to 546 by 273 into 22.4, that is divided by 2, that is equal to 44.8 liters. Look here, friend, PV is equal to energy. But the gas is at STP. At STP, 273 Kelvin, the gas is always occupied 22.4 liters. But when we measure the temperature in the given problem is 273 degrees. This will be converted to Kelvin. 273 plus 273, that is equal to 546 Kelvin. So 273 Kelvin is otherwise 32.4 liter. But at 546 Kelvin, how much it will be occupied? It occupied 44.8 liters. So this is another model of in this chapter. Friends, look here. Another important thing is the density of a gas 2.5 grams per liter at 127 degrees and 1 atmosphere, then the molecular weight of a gas is equal to what is the density of a gas 2.5 grams and 127 degrees C, 120 degrees and 1 atmosphere? Then what is the molecular weight of a, what is the molecular weight of a gas? Let in this problem, this is by using PM is equal to dT. This is the formula to calculate the molecular weight of any compound. So M is equal to dRT by M. D is nothing but the density. R is the gas constant, T is the temperature, P is the pressure. In the given problem, the density is always equal to 2.5 and then R is nothing but 0.0821 and then D is nothing but 127 degrees. The 127 degrees can be converted into 2750. It forms 400 Kelvin. Then you can go 400 Kelvin. So, that the pressure of the gas is always given at 1 atm. So then you can calculate 82.1 grams per mole. Thanks. So these are the important models of states of matter. Again, we can discuss about some more problems in this chapter with another.